Hello guys, welcome to my 9th class of Laplace Transfer. In this class, I am going to discuss unit step function. Unit step function is one of the important functions. We are using so many areas, just like way in the signaling system, mechanical vibration. Not only here, we are going to use this unit step function while expressing probability function, especially for continuous probability distribution function. We are expressing by using unit step function. For example, Wolkoff probability distribution, uniform distribution. In all the cases, in high level, I'm talking about in PG level, we are considering these distribution. In these distribution, we are going to represent by using unit step function. If a unit step function is one of the important property and not one of the important concepts. Therefore, first you have to know what's the definition of unit step function. Not only we are considering unit step function, we are taking another name is nothing but Heaviside unit function. Heaviside unit step function or unit step function both are must be same. Here I am defining unit step function based on t shifted some particular point say a. Therefore, that is the way I have taken u of t minus a. 0 until t is less than a is 1 for t is greater than or equal to a. Suppose you plot a graph for this unit step function on every side, up to less than a, what's the value? 0. Therefore, we get the horizontal line lies on x axis. And next, once you reach a, even though it is more than a also, what we get suddenly is to shifted to which point? 1 unit. And then move to horizontally. Now, suppose you look like this graph here. This is look like a what staircase. The first we get is a horizontal line. Suddenly jump 1 unit, and then we get another horizontal line. Therefore, this function is considered step function. Why get little unit? Because the shifted how much value? 1 value. Therefore, this is nothing but unit step function or Heaviside function. Then suppose a is not shifted to any the point a is 0, then u of t unit step function is nothing but 0 for t is less than a, 1 for t is greater than or equal to 0. This is nothing but particular thing of Heaviside function. Now, in some cases, some problem they are going to ask to express the given function in terms of unit step function and then find out the corresponding Laplace transform. In such cases, we are going to express by using this unit step function, and also while solving that, we are using following these two formula or result. The first one, Laplace transform of u of t minus a is nothing but e power of minus as by s. How we get this? You know what is u of t minus a. Now you take Laplace transform of u of t minus a. Now we get actually what is our limit is actually 0 to infinity u of t minus a, that's our f of t into e power of minus st dt. Now I have to split the integral 0 to 1, 0 to a, yes, and then I have to split the thing is what, a to infinity. 0 to a, what happened, the function is 0, therefore we are going to neglect this is a 0. But greater than a to infinity means what, t is greater than a, what is the value, 1 into e power of minus st dt. Now I have to simplify this, I think everyone is clear. Then you have to simplify and evaluate. Now we get the value is nothing but what actually e power of as by s, because we have to integrate. What's the integration of e power of minus st? E power of minus st by s minus s, because quotient of t is minus s, what's the limit? 0 to a to infinity. I'll keep minus 1 by s outside. E power of minus infinity, I discussed in my previous class, e power of minus infinity is 1 by e power of infinity. E power of infinity is infinity. What's the value? 1 by infinity is 0. 0 minus the row element e power of minus as. Simplify that, what we get here, e power of minus as divided by s. Therefore, the Laplace transform of Heaviside function of t minus a is nothing but e power of minus as by s. Similarly, suppose I put a is 0, I put a 0, what happened? Laplace transform of u of t is e power of 0, what is e power of 0 is 1 divided by s. Therefore, Laplace transform of u of t is nothing but 1 by s. This is a Laplace transform of this function. Okay. Next is, some cases we are expressing in terms of unit step function, Heaviside function. There we are using another one result is nothing but Laplace transform of f of t minus e into u of t minus a is one of the result is nothing but e power of minus a s into f of s. This also we get just like what we discussed just now. Similarly we get this. This formula is very much useful whenever I am going to find out Laplace transform after you express the given function in terms of unit step function. This is a formula. Please try to remember Laplace transform of f of t minus a into u of t minus a is equal to e power of minus a s into capital F of s. Capital F of s is nothing but what? Laplace transform of f of t. Now if you want to know the proof of this, you refer my website. I am going to upload my notes, KMR bitmaps, then we get the proof of this also. Okay. Now I am going to take based on this some problems, how to express in terms of unit step function and also how to solve the problem by using these two results. What are the results I explained now? Yeah. Now I am going to take first problem. Yes. First problem is, for example, express f of t equals 1 for t is greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1, t for t is greater than 1. In terms of Heaviside's unit step function, and hence find its Laplace transform. It's LT, I'm going to write LT means Laplace transform. First, we express f of t in terms of unit step function. After that, and then find its Laplace transform. Now, here the solution is first you have to express the given function in terms of unit step function. Now, this f of t can be written as, now what's the first function you have in the splitting function 1? 1 is range between what? 0 to 1. Therefore, 1 into u of t minus a is 0 minus u of t minus shifting point is 1. Yeah. Now I am going to explain once again. Plus second function is t, but they have only t greater than 1. Therefore u of t minus 1. Now observe carefully. This is a way to express. This is one of the result we are going to discuss to express unit step function. Now how to express? This is t rise between 0 to 1, that function, what you have in this range function into u of t minus a is 0, minus r, u of t minus, this is the value of a is what? 1. Plus here having only one function, but t is greater than 1, t into u of t minus 1. After expressing, this is the way I have to express in terms of Heaviside unit step function, means u of t minus a. You already know that u of t minus a is our unit step function is 0 for t is less than a, and then 1 for t is greater than or equal to a. This is a way to express unit step function. After that, I want to find out Laplace. But you can't find out Laplace. You have to express, you know, Laplace transform of f of t minus a to u of t minus a. What's the formula I told? E power of minus as into Laplace transform of f of t or capital F of s. I can express like that. F of t is nothing but 1. Yeah, 1 can be written as 1 minus 0 into u of t minus 0. Now here having 2 t minus 1, I'll group these two. Yeah. Yes, what's a common factor actually? U of t minus 1 is a common. What's the remaining? Minus 1 plus t. This is my, this is f of t. I can express f of t minus a. What is area? 1. Therefore, I can express this flower bracket function also in which form? T minus 1. Because a is 1. Now we get 1 minus 0. U of t minus 0. I take what's the common f. What's the value I'm going to take outside? Minus 1. U of t minus 1 into 1 minus t. Now observe. These two terms is look like this. U of t minus 0, f of a minus t minus a. You are clear or not? 1 minus 0. Now here, what is my f of t minus a? 1 minus 0. What is f of t minus a in this case is? What about that? Once you take minus sign, what we get? T minus 1. Yes? This is my f of t minus a. Now both the term in the form of f of t minus a, u of t minus a. Now I will go for Laplace. Now apply this formula, easily we get Laplace transform. Therefore, Laplace transform of f of t, here I have two terms. I take Laplace transform of the first term minus Laplace transform of the second term by using which property? Linear property. T minus 1 into u of t minus 1. Now we are going to use one of the formula. We know that Laplace transform of f of t minus a into u of t minus a is equal to what actually? E power of minus as into capital F of s. Keep in mind capital F of s is nothing but Laplace transform of the given function. Therefore, Laplace transform of f of t we get actually here what is e power of 0, 0 into s into Laplace transform of 1. F of t, what is here? 1. Minus, what is the value of a is 1, e power of 1 into s. Laplace, f capital f of s is nothing but Laplace transform of f of t other than minus a. What is other than minus 1 here? T, Laplace transform of t. Now we know that, what's the Laplace transform of 1? Laplace transform of 1 is 1 by s. You already derived this result. And also Laplace transform of t power of n is nothing but n factorial divided by s to the power of n plus 1. Therefore, now we get finally Laplace transform of f of t is equal to 1 by s minus e power of minus s into Laplace transform of t. N is equal to 1. 1 factorial divided by s square. Therefore, what we get? 1 by s minus e power of minus s by s square. This is way to find out Laplace transform after you express in terms of the unit step function. This is one of the, look like a very simple. I am going to repeat once again because it's a very, very important. How to solve the problem? How to express first given function in terms of unit step function? Now, how to express a ready set or unit step function? You take f of t, take first function. If suppose it defined in the two intervals, that what we define the function into u of the first value, t minus a is nothing but first value of the limit, lower limit, minus u of t minus of upper limit. Plus, you go to the next one, here having only one interval, therefore u of t minus 1. Suppose again having t must be like skipping 1 and 2 means what we are going to take u of t minus 1 minus of u of t minus 2 like that. Are you clear? This is nothing but that express in terms of which form? This is nothing but that express in terms of Heaviside unit step function. Unit step function. Okay? And next I want to find out the value. We are going to adopt this formula. Because once you convert that form, then easy to write what is my Laplace transform. Therefore, what we are going to do here, now I correct the term, t minus 1 term and also correct t minus 0 term. Now here, 1 can be written as 1 minus 0, my a is 0, here a is 1. I can express this value, f of t also in which form? F of t minus a, therefore what I did, I take the minus sign outside. Immediately we get in the form of f of t minus 1 into u of t minus 1. The both are done in the form of this formula. Therefore, I am going to apply a Laplace transform. After applying the Laplace transform, for all my convenient, I am going to write what's the formula for this. What's the formula? E power of minus as by e power of minus as into f of s. What is f of s? Is nothing but Laplace transform of f of t. Now, after once you apply the formula, what we get? What is a here? 0. And then f of t other than 0. What is other than 0 here? 1. Laplace transform 1. Minus e power of as. What is a is 1 into s. Laplace transform of other than 1. What is other than 1 is t. Now, we already know that what is Laplace transform 1 and Laplace of t. Then I have to substitute. This is a way to solve the problem by using unit step function, a heavy side unit step function. Okay, thank you very much for listening my talk. I am going to take one or two problems in for my further.